and not keep intense emotions. The third balance is financial balance. It is, people say, paise mein kuch nahi rakha. It is not like that. You must be financially secure in life to be healthy. A poor man who doesn't know what he will eat at night can think of nothing else. He can only think of his next meal. He cannot think of health. So today we must do those activities in life by which we secure ourselves, our family and our future, so that our mind is free to focus on the greater purpose of life. So financial balance is very important. It has a direct impact on mental and physical health. The fourth balance is social balance. See, always blend well with society. Always blend well with neighbors and family. You must be a source of joy to others wherever we go. Second thing, give back to the world more than what you have taken from it. That is the duty of every person. The third thing is, you are not replaceable in your family. So don't waste 18 hours working on your job just to earn money. There must be a balance. Because if you will miss out on your family life, if you will not see your children growing up, these joys you will never get later on in life. And in old age, you will have a lot of repentance for having missed out on the beauty of your own family life just because you were earning money. So there must be a balance between financial security and social balance. These balances are very important. I know people who don't go with their families on vacation. The wife goes, the son goes, the daughter goes. Father saying, main nahi ja sakta hu, mera to business chal raha hai yahan pe. But later on in old age, he'll realize what he has missed out. And the last balance in life is spiritual balance. This is a very, very important balance. Although this is a health presentation, I will clearly say that we are not born for eating and digesting food. That is not the purpose of our life. We must attempt to understand the higher purpose, why we are born. We must think, who am I? What am I here for? If you don't have spiritual balance, life becomes purposeless. I'll just give an example. Suppose there is a football field. There are two goals over here. And the players are running on the field, trying to secure a goal on this side or the other side. So the game is very interesting and everybody watches it. Now I remove the goalpost and I throw them away. The whole game becomes meaningless. The players are just running here and there with a ball, not knowing what to do. So in life, it is like that only. If you don't have a spiritual goal in life, no matter how busy you are just running here and there, thinking you are busy and you are productive. But actually, at the end of life, nothing has been accomplished because there never was a goal in life only. So, you must have a spiritual goal towards which we must work. And if we disconnect with the divine and get lost in the world, all life dries up, all health also finally dries up. So, when we keep these five balances, the physical balance, the mental balance, the financial balance, the social balance, and the spiritual balance, that man's attitude is always positive because it's a balanced attitude. It is not a one-sided attitude. And a positive attitude will help that person always remain healthy. Now we come to the third pillar of health. The third pillar of health is rest. Rest must not be confused with sleep. I can sleep 8 hours, but I may not rest. Suppose I have a lot of problems. I think of those problems at night, go to sleep, morning I get up, facing the same problems. So I have slept, but I have not taken rest. Rest is when the mind sleeps. When the mind sleeps, the body repairs itself much, much better. But I don't know how to rest. I know only how to sleep. So how do I rest? In yoga, there is one asana which is shavasana. If we practice shavasana every day, it relaxes the body, it relaxes the mind, and you stay healthy in a relaxed body. It is better to sleep for 6 hours and do shavasana for 20 minutes than sleep for 9 hours and not do shavasana. So shavasana is one thing we must incorporate in our life for actual rest. See how tricky the mind is. The mind will not easily let you rest. I'll just tell a small story. Once there was a king, aur wo bahut bimar pada. And he tried all sorts of medicines. Then he announced, I'll give half my kingdom to someone who can cure me. One day one person came to him, gave him a bottle, said, Raja, ye bottle lo, if you drink this, you will become all right. It's just a story. So, but there is one condition. When you pick up this bottle, you must not think of a dancing monkey. And he did all the actions of a dancing monkey and showed him. Raja said, okay, in my 40 years of life, I have never thought of a dancing monkey, so where is the problem? Then the sadhu went away. At night, the Raja picked up the bottle to take the medicine. And the first thought which came in the mind is the dancing monkey only. He had never thought of it before ever. But aaj jab wo bottle dekhta hai, it is connected with the dancing monkey. And so, this is how the mind works. The mind is not so simple. You have to train it. We cannot tame the mind. A wild elephant, you cannot tame. You cannot train it. First you have to tame it, then you have to train it. It's like that. So, Savasan we must incorporate in our life for rest. It is just written, it is good to work for 8 hours and sleep for 8 hours. But not the same 8 hours. The fourth pillar of good health is nutrition. Because finally our body is made up of what we eat only. So we have to be very careful in what we eat, because our body will be made up out of that. Now, in nutrition, I'll just explain in short. In the body there is a metabolic process. You are not in the same body what you were about 12 years ago. Every 4 months the blood changes. Every 10 days the stomach lining changes. Because there's so much acid being secreted in the stomach. Every 8 years our bones change. Step by step, cell by cell, part by part. So 10 years ago I was in a different body compared to what I am now. So the body is continually building up, which is anabolism, continually breaking down, which is catabolism. It is like a plant. You plant a seed, it germinates, it grows into a plant, it comes to the maintenance stage where it stays as a plant, and slowly it morphifies and dies. Our life is also like that. We are born, we grow, in middle age we maintain, and in old age the body becomes shrunk and later on we die. This is called the aging process. No one can stop the aging process. But with a proper living, we can always slow it down. We can slow down our aging process. Now we come to food. The food which we eat gives us two things basically. One, it gives us calories. Lot calories are required for our daily activity. If I have to walk from here to here, I need energy. Who will give that? Calories. But don't all of us sitting here, none of us have to worry about calories, because we always take in more calories than what we need. Whatever you eat contains calories. If you eat rice, you have calories. If you eat dal, you have calories. If you eat pani puri, you have 100 calories. If you eat one fried puri, you have 100 calories. You need about 2000 calories a day, maximum. So calories to we get in excess. But what else we need is nutrition. Nutrition is of two, macro and micro. Macro means which is required in large quantity, micro which is required in small quantities. In macro we have proteins, and in micro we have vitamins and minerals. If my weight is 80 kilos, I need 80 grams of good protein every day. And I need 13 vitamins and 11 minerals, 24 things I need in all. With these 24 vitamins and the proteins, the body makes 10 lakh combinations every day. It produces insulin, hormones, hair, teeth, blood, skin, bone. Everything is finally made out of proteins. So all these combinations are produced by the body because we get proteins and we get 24 vitamins and minerals. Now what happens? My diet always may not be healthy. I may be very busy to take care of myself. I just go down and have vada pav, or I go to McDonald's and have something, or I just eat while standing. So I don't, sometimes what happens, I may not get the 24 vitamins and minerals which I need. Then the problem starts. I'll give you an example. Take the letters of the English alphabet, 26 letters, A, B, C, D, E, F. And there are 5 vowels, A, E, I, O, and U. And I can make lakhs of words from the alphabet. I can make lakhs of words. But if I remove the five vowels, A, E, I, O, and U, I can hardly make 20 words from the English alphabet. So my body needs 24 vitamins and minerals. If I don't take 5 or 6, thousands of combinations will not take place in the body. But the body is very kind. It says, aaj ka din mai chala lunga. Tomorrow it tells you, aaj bhi mai chala lunga. But month after month, it won't say ke mai chala lunga. And then disease starts developing at the cellular level. And slowly it affects the organs and it affects the systems. So no disease comes suddenly. It is always the consequence of a very long neglect of proper nutrition. This is a wall. Now wall needs bricks and cement. Similarly, we need proteins and we need those vitamins and minerals for our body wall to become strong. I'll just talk a little about free radicals. It's very important. Previously, bimari bahar thi, like cholera germs. They would enter the system, no medicine was there and person would die of cholera. Now nobody dies of cholera. Abhi bahar ki bimari we have conquered. Abhi bimari andar hai apne mein. Hypertension, stress, diabetes, blood pressure and so many other things. That is because of free radical damage. Because of smoking, drinking, fast life, stress, tension, fried food, fast food, eating out of time, eating any time, what happens in the body, a lot of free radicals are produced. These free radicals attack the cells. They attack the cells. I'll tell you what a free radical is. That same oxygen which supports our life, if it proper, it destroys us. You take a garden. After 1 week, you go there, it is rusted. You take an apple and cut it and keep it. After 10 minutes, it becomes brown. That is because the oxygen attacks it and oxidizes it. Actually, what is an oxygen atom? It is like this. An oxygen atom has a center nucleus and it has 8 electrons moving around it. 8 electrons. Free radical mein kya hota hai? Oxygen atom is incomplete. It has only 7 electrons. So this becomes unstable. It wants to become stable. So it is searching for an electron. So wo kya karta hai? Baju mein jo oxygen atom hai, vahan se it takes 1 electron and this becomes complete, this becomes incomplete. Then this one searches another one and this becomes complete, the next becomes incomplete and a chain reaction starts in the body. Whichever part it takes place, maximum it damages that part of the body. So for free radicals, we have to take antioxidants. I'll just give you an example of free radical. This is one vessel in which there's rice. These are like the cells of our body. Now, our body, just like the earth, is 70% water. The world is 70% water. Our body is also 70% water. So this is how our body is when we were born, when we grew up. It was so pure. Now I take a substance called betadine. Betadine is a solution which we apply when children fall down. It just kills the germs. So what I am doing is, I am pouring betadine in the body. Actually no one drinks betadine. But we take in so many harmful things, polluted air, wrong food, fast food, junk food, alcohol, like I said. So because of all that thing, finally inside our body it is like this. Outside we may be very beautiful, but our body inside is in this stage of health. Now this stage of health is bound to create disease, if not now, after 2 years, 3 years, 4 years. And we are bound to have a diseased body. Now what do we do about it? We have to detoxify this body. The best detoxifying agent is vitamin C. If we take vitamin C every day, this is vitamin C, this is a tablet of vitamin C. It's a natural tablet made out of cherries which are very rich in vitamin C. What am I doing? I am pouring vitamin C in the body. This experiment is only for visual purposes. Now every day when I take vitamin C, it detoxifies the body and it removes all the toxins. and it tries to bring the body back to its original state. So our diet must regularly have vitamin C. See, this is how vitamin C works in the body. It brings the body back to its original purity. So we must have a